everyone. I know I'm looking a little casual today, but you know, it's okay. This is a casual video. And yeah, now that I'm thinking about it, some of you are gonna be like, Cassie, you are wearing purple lipstick. That is not casual. Well, you know, to each their own. But basically, since school is about to start up, slash I know some of you have already started school, I am so sorry. I was in summer classes all summer, so I kind of feel your pain. I figure this is kind of the appropriate time to do a video about school, in particular about college. Basically, I've written down 10 things about college, slash things that I wish I would have known about college, slash things I learned in I don't know. I'm hoping I'll have come up with a more articulate title by the time I edit and post this video. And also a little like disclaimer, everyone who goes to college is going to have a different experience. Mine is not the be-all, end-all, nor is it the stereotypical experience. It's just my experience. I graduated in 2012, so I went from 2008 to 2012 getting my undergrad degree, and I was pre-dental my first 3 years, and then I switched over and was just studio art. I was a studio art major all 4 years. I just was also doing the dentistry thing while I was doing the art. The art major was kind of to keep my sanity and so that I had an excuse to take some art classes while I was doing all of my sciencey stuff. And then in the end, I just decided to switch over to be an art professor one day because that's what I ended up falling in love with. I feel like these school feelings are fresh and I want to tell you about them while I still remember, because I know a few years from now, it's gonna be like high school. I'm not gonna remember a thing except for how awkward I was. Yeah, cheers to another school year here. Ugh, we're doing it together, people. We're doing it together. All right, the first thing that I wrote down, it's pretty simple and straightforward, but I think it's a very important thing to remember and understand while you are away at college, and that is that change will be everywhere. It's gonna be happening with you, it's gonna be happening with the people around you, it's gonna be happening to the people that are back home away from you. I mean, think about it. You're transitioning from high school into college. They are completely different from each other, you guys. Seriously, I don't care how many AP classes you took in high school, I was that kid too. Like, I was your typical straight A honors student kid in high school. Well, college is very different, and it's gonna change you. I don't care who you are. College is a defining kind of time in your life, and many changes are gonna be happening on your outsides, because puberty never ends, it seems like, and changes will also be happening on the inside. Your emotions are going to be everywhere. Get used to them. Snuggle up with them, because it's gonna be a long ride. If you're the typical college kid, it's gonna be a 4 years. 4 years of those emotions, so make friends early, rather than later on like I did. And then also the people around you, you know, in your dorm, your roommate, your friends that you're making at college, whatever, they're having that same college experience. So not only are you growing and changing, but so are they. So things are never stagnant in college, and I just think you gotta embrace that change while you can. And like I said, starting early is much better than starting late. The second thing that I wrote down is that you really should be making sure that you are going to college for the right reasons. If you're going there to please your parents, I knew some people in college that only went to college to find a husband. Yeah, that's a real thing. Make sure that you are going for you, for school reasons, not you for marriage reasons. This is really kind of like,
hello,
a sad statement to make, but no one's going to be there to encourage you and push you and make you go to class and make you do your homework. No one really cares. Like, that is all up to you. It's not gonna be like in high school where if all of a sudden, you know, you're a typical AB type student and then all of a sudden you take a test and you got a D on it, your teacher's not gonna come up to you and be like, oh my gosh, like, what's going on in your life? They don't care. I mean, granted, some professors do care about their students, but I mean, especially if you're going to a big college where you've got 200, 300, whatever, sitting with you in the auditorium, you know, if they even know your name, that you're lucky. It's just no one's gonna be there to tell you excuse my language, to get your shit together. You know, get your shit done. You gotta trust me when I say that if you don't care about the classes that you're taking, you won't go to class. You won't do your homework. There are so many things that can and will distract you, and you will find every excuse in the book to not do these things. Like, oh, I'm tired. I don't feel like going to class. My stomach feels a little weird. I'm not gonna go. I'd rather go to this party than do my homework. I'd rather watch Netflix than do my homework. You won't do it. I mean, you have to remember, you are the one that is paying for that professor to be there and teach you things. If you don't go to class, that's basically you throwing hundreds of dollars away each time you don't go. The third thing I wanted to say is kind of also a self-explanatory thing, but it's something that can be very easy to forget while you're in college, and that is to take care of yourself. In the sleeping terms of things, you know, that's not really going to be an option most of the time. I mean, it's going to depend on your major and how efficient you are with doing your homework, but for the typical college student, sleep will not be a big part of their lives. But other than that, you pretty much have control of the other health aspects that are going on. Make the time to go work out. That is something that was so important for me while I was in college. Just being able to go and run for even a half an hour, you know, maybe 4 or 5 times a week. It is so helpful to relieve stress and just take your mind off of things. And like I said, it's also keeping you healthy. It's keeping your mind alert. It's keeping you awake. And trust me, I am the last person that wants to move their body. Like, I am the ultimate couch potato. And I hate working out. I get so sweaty. Like, trust me, I am the ugliest person at the gym. You probably would not even recognize me if you saw me sweating. But the feeling afterward and just the overall benefits, they really are worth it. Aside from working out, you can also eat right. I know, it's hard at the cafeteria. There are all of those yummy options and bad for you options, especially in like the desserts, like cookies and stuff. And sometimes your emotions need to be fed. That's great. Do that like once a month, but don't do it every day. Just make sure you're feeding your body right, and that's really going to help feed your mind as well, and it's just going to make your life a whole lot easier while you're doing all that studying and going to class. All right, number four. The peer pressure at college is unbelievable in the most horrible of ways. It's there. It's gonna be there every single day and all around you. You know, hey, let's go get drunk. Hey, let's go binge on a bunch of food at the caf to make ourselves feel better. Hey, let's do some drugs. You know, whatever it is, it's going to be there, and it is going to be hard to say no. If you thought high school was hard, try college, where you're trying even harder to make friends and fit in. I just feel like the media and society that we live in, they've created this huge, like, party, drug, alcohol culture that goes with college. So people, like, feel the need to have that aspect of college in their college lives, and it's just, it doesn't need to happen. I promise you, there are people out there that don't go to parties every weekend and don't drink themselves silly every weekend. You will find them. They are there. You don't have to change yourself to have fun. You can be yourself and have fun and have others be there who love you for who you are. It's such a shame, and especially for, you know, the kids that are going right into college after high school. And yes, kids, I don't care that you're 18, you are a child. Notice how there is still a teen in the number of your age, because you're still a teenager. I don't care how adult you think you are, you're still a kid. You still don't know anything. I'm 24 and I'm still a kid. I don't know anything. I pay my bills and I do not consider myself an adult yet, so. Things happen, you guys, and alcohol can kill you. Drugs can kill you. They do it to someone every single day in this world, and you might just be that person. I feel like this is turning out to be a really depressing video, but I love you guys, and I want to make sure that you're making good choices. How many of you watch Lifetime? Hands up. It's not glamorous, you know? There is absolutely nothing glamorous about your head being stuck in a toilet at 3 in the morning and calling your mom crying. Like, I did that too many times to be comfortable to admit. Thank you, Mom, and I'm sorry. Number 5, not 10, 5. Really simple and really easy, but it's also something very simple and very easy to forget, and that is to call home. Mom, if you're watching this video, you're probably gonna cry, but I found the biggest support system through my mom while I was in college, and I don't think I'll ever be able to thank her enough. I think it is so important. I don't care if you got along with your parents while you were in high school or if you didn't. They're there for you and they love you, and if you're like most kids out there, they're helping you pay for your college, and it's because they care about you and want you to have the best. My mom and I haven't always had the best relationship, but once I got to college, I leaned on her so much, and oh my gosh, now I'm getting emotional. I know so many people, even other than I know so many people other than just me that weren't on such great terms with their parents in high school, but during college, they found this whole new relationship with them, and it can be a really, really wonderful thing, and I'm so appreciative of my mom for everything she did for me while I was in college and for the emotional support that she provided with me. I know that you're gonna be caught up with your friends and with your schoolwork and stuff, but I just think even once a week, just calling home and saying, hey, how you doing? I think is a really good thing for both you and your parents. Oh my gosh, I'm glad I didn't wear eye makeup. I wasn't expecting to cry. But I really do think that it's one of the best places that you can turn for support. And, you know, parents are there to love you unconditionally, so you should treasure that while you can. On a bit more of a depressing note, number 6 is, this is kind of more of a life thing, but friends are gonna come and go. I definitely lost some of my closest friends during college, and not lost by like they died, but we're not friends anymore and we don't talk anymore, and it's rough. It's really hard. You know, like I said, you are going to be going through changes and they're going to be going through changes too. If you're going to college, they're probably going to college and not necessarily the same one, and changes are going to happen and it's going to be hard, especially, you know, since Facebook is a thing and you see pictures and you read people's walls and whatnot, and people are caught up in getting to know their new friends, and so they don't stay in contact as well with their old friends, and it can be very messy, and that is why I really don't go on Facebook anymore, because I think it is more destructive than it is constructive. It's a tough lesson to learn, but your friends are definitely gonna come and go in cycles, and at least in the end, you know who your true friends are. I definitely did get much closer to many of my friends while I was in college as well, for the same reasons that I lost some of them. Definitely try to keep your friends in your life, stay in contact with them, but also know that it's not a guarantee that you will stay friends with the same people, and unfortunately, that's just a fact of life. Number 7 is kind of something quick and easy that I think everyone can and should do, and it's definitely something that helped me keep my sanity through my 4 years of undergrad, and that is to find something that you love and do it every single day. Yes, 7 days a week, all day, but not all day. You know, just do it for like 10 minutes. For me, it was Sudoku and Jason Mraz. Every single night, I mean, granted, I probably missed a couple nights, like every semester, but before I went to bed, I would put in my headphones, listen to Jason Mraz live at Java Joe's, it's the best CD ever, and just lay there and do some Sudoku for 15, 20 minutes, maybe 10 if I was really tired. It really helps you to kind of focus and center yourself before you go to bed at night, just kind of forget about everything that you're worrying about and everything that's stressing you out at the moment, and just relax and enjoy that one little pleasurable thing. Number 8 is something that kind of correlates to some of the other things I've already talked about, and also something that may seem kind of self-explanatory or like, oh, duh, of course I'm gonna do that, but you know, it can be easy to forget while you're in college, and that is to ask for help whenever you need it. I don't care if it is with your coursework, you know, going to a tutor, going to after-class sessions, or even going to your professor. If it's with your daily duties, you know, if you need help with, I don't know, like, oh my gosh, like, I really don't have time to wash my 2 dishes in the sink tonight. Dear roommate, can you please do them for me? or, you know, if you need a workout buddy to get you to the gym, or with your life, if you are struggling with any sort of deep personal thoughts, issues, you know, depression, alcohol dependency, whatever, any of these things, there are counselors you can go to, there are friends that you can talk to, people in your life that you can talk to. Just, it is so important to ask for help when you need it. And it is something that took me a very long time to be able to do, and it is still something that I struggle with. I feel like a lot of people have that problem. It does not make you a weak person to ask for help. I think that is one of the biggest things that I personally struggle with, is that I feel like, oh my gosh, I can't believe, like, I am so weak that I can't even get through this myself. I know that struggle, and it sucks, and it is really hard. Just going for help when you need it, it's helpful. The people that are there, you know, tutors especially, counselors especially, that's their job. They like doing that stuff, you know? Most of them, be it a professor or a counselor, whatever, you know, they had to go to extra schooling to be able to do that job. So trust me when I say, they probably enjoy it when people come to them for help. I know that is something that I love when I teach my students, is when they ask me questions and ask for help with something, you know? Like, that's what I'm there for. I'm there to give you advice. Trust me when I say that people will not look down on you for asking for help. And if they do look down on you, they probably need help themselves. Number 9 is something that seems impossible to do, but it is something that is very important to do just kind of in life in general, and that is to stop comparing yourself to others. Now, when you are living with roommates and going to college especially, it is a very hard thing to do. Especially when you are looking for your new self, changes are happening, you know, and you're like, who do I want to become? And you see these perfect, stereotypical, beautiful people walking around your campus or whatever. It's really hard not to be like, I want to be that person, so I'm gonna do everything I can to be like that person. And it is unhealthy, and it is not good, because you are you, and that's beautiful. You watching this video, I don't care how you feel about yourself, but I'm telling you that you are beautiful and you are wonderful, unless you're a serial killer, in which case we have other things to talk about. Really, there's nothing wrong with you being you, and you do not need to compare yourself to other people. They're not perfect, and there's already one of them in this world. We don't need another one. They're good enough on their own. We need you to be you. It's not the place to be comparing apples to oranges. They will never be the same. They are two different fruits, and they are lovely. And honestly, eaten together, apples and oranges are delicious. I would not want to be without one of them. All right, last one here, you guys. I know this is probably gonna be a long video, but number 10, don't sweat the small stuff. I know, Cassie, how can you say that? That is like the hardest thing to not do. Well, you'll be better off for not doing it. So I'm just letting you know, especially when it comes to things like your schoolwork and whatnot. If you are good about keeping on top of things and like seeing, oh my gosh, in 2 weeks, I'm gonna have 2 tests plus an essay plus these club activity things that I'm gonna need to be doing all on the same day. All right, let's see, what can we take out of this equation? Your professor's probably not gonna move a test, so nope, not those ones. But hey, we've got an essay right here. Maybe I can ask the professor for an extension of a couple days. That's a thing. And you know what? More often than not, professors are going to give you that extension, especially if you're not like asking for a 2-week extension, you know, just like a few days. And especially if you ask a couple weeks ahead of time, not like an hour before the paper is due, they're probably going to be like, sure, like that's fine, just get it into me. Poof! Poof! No need to sweat that small essay that's actually probably 20 pages long. But like, you know, you just gave yourself 48 more hours. Perfect! And all you had to do was shoot an email to a professor. Done! Easy! Life hack! And then also, small stuff like, oh my god, how does my hair look? Oh, does my makeup perfect today? What should I wear? If you take a second to look around you, most people are going to be in sweatpants, not wearing makeup, haven't showered in more days than they probably should have. Most people that are in class, they just want to go home and take a nap. They're not really sitting there like, I need to evaluate all of the other students in this classroom and compare myself to them. No, No one's really doing that. Look at yourself. Are you really doing that? Are you judging that kid in the sweatpants with two coffees? No. You're probably just saying, wow, he probably had a long night. I hope he takes a nap when he gets home. Give yourself at least that much. You know, you're fine the way you are. All right, so that is it, you guys. That was my 10 college things or whatever I'm gonna call this. I hope it was helpful. I hope you enjoyed. Like I said, I really do wish I had known a lot of these things before I started college, but unfortunately I did not learn until probably my last year of college. College is just an experience in itself. It's gonna have its good times, it's gonna have its bad times, but you can make it through so long as you have a good support system, so long as you are treating yourself well, and so long as you are happy doing what you're doing. I have faith in you, I have confidence that you can achieve your dreams and you can do well in college. It really can be the best and most beautiful experience of your life if you know how to get through it and how to get the most enjoyment out of it possible. As always, I hope you guys are well, and until next time, just stay well until then. Bye!